take. Oh my gosh, you guys, I cannot get this together. Like, I cannot get it together at all. My voice is like out of there, and I'm trying to tell my story. Like, really, like, voice, thyroids, get it together. Get it together. Okay. So today I'm telling you my reason of how I gained the weight. This is going to be emotional, so if you're not an emotional being, then this is not for you, because I am documenting my weight loss journey. So good vibes, and much love. And welcome to my channel, you guys. I hope you guys are enjoying the whole weight loss journey series and all that good stuff. So let's get right to it. So how did I gain the weight? Well, when I got pregnant with my son, because before I was pregnant with my son, I was 160 pounds thick, like sexy thick, like Coca-Cola bottle shape. I got pregnant with my son, which was a huge blessing to me. It wasn't expected. It wasn't like we were trying to have a child or we were looking to have a child. It was a miracle, because the doctor said, oh, you're not able to have kids. And if you guys see the camera shaking, it's because I don't have myself. Y'all know how it goes. But the doctor said that I wasn't able to have kids, and God showed them wrong. But yeah, I got pregnant with AJJ, and then I started to eat and eat and eat and eat and eat. Okay, and that's what a pregnant mama do. That's what she does. That's what she knows. Like, cravings. That's you guys, sorry for the throat, because thyroids is taking over today. But yes. I ate and ate and ate, and I went to the doctor to see why I was eating so much. And the doctor was like, no, it's just the baby. It has nothing to do with you. It's just the baby. Yeah. It was actually me and the baby, like towards my eighth month. But before all that, like when I was, you know, I told his dad and all that, and he decided he wanted to be invisible. And when I mean be invisible, be a, you know, I don't want to call him a deadbeat. And I know that's the general word for fathers that don't want to be in their kid's life, but I just want to say he wants to be absent out of his son's life. So that took a toll on me as well, just knowing that I'm about to be a single mama. I'm gonna do this by myself. I had so much stuff going through my head. My mom was A1. She was number one in my life. Like, she was always there, her and my sister. And it was, every time I think about it, it's because my mom was, girl, do this, get up and do this, you have to do this. Like, even when my birth, my mom was there. She was in the labor room, because I did have him C-section. So, but she was there, her and my sister. And, I mean, it was just her and my sister, nobody else. And, you know, I was praying a lot. I was depressed. I was emotional, stressed out, because I'm about to be a new mom. I'm about to be a single mom. And I said I was going to cry. I'm not going to cry. You guys, I'm not going to cry. It's going to be emotional, but I'm not going to cry. You know. But yeah, it started when I found out. Yeah, like, that I was going to be a single mom. It found out. Like, I started stressing. I started being depressed. Postpartum was excuse my French, a bitch. So, I just couldn't wrap my head around that I was going to be a single parent until God pulled me in and held me close and told me, you can do this. You can do this. You got this. And I told God, I said, if you have my back in this, take that bad person out of my life. And guess what God did? He took that person out of my life. I've been happy ever since with my son. And so that now I want to tell you about my thyroids and why. So, I found out that I had them when, of course, you find out a lot of stuff when you're pregnant. So I found out that I had thyroids in my neck, and sometimes it flares up, like a lot. And my voice, like, it takes my voice away a lot. And that has to do with emotionally eating, because whenever it does, it's like a heart. It feels like a heart rock, and I know that I need to get that procedure done, but I just haven't had time. I know I need to make time, and it shouldn't be an excuse, but it can take over, like, your throat, and you be like, I want to eat this, eat that. And I don't know if it mess with my appetite or what, but I be eating like a lot. And I don't know, you know, it's just, it takes over and it does its thing. Like, it takes over my throat life. It takes over it, you know. But when I first, like, figured it out, I was just like, I started reading, researching and stuff like that, making smoothies and eating healthy and stuff like that, but it did not work. So, and even, like, the doctor was like, maybe before you get your procedure, you want to, like, do this and do that, and I did that, and nothing was working, so... that was the issue with that, because I haven't got the procedure. That's why I constantly try to eat, because it hurts a lot to eat. So when I do get a chance to eat, when it's not hurting, I'm eating a whole lot before it hurts. So, I guess the reason why that weight put on is because that was absolutely my fault, because I did not get that procedure when I was supposed to. I was afraid, like, I was really afraid to get that procedure, and now I'm thinking about just go ahead and doing it, because most of the time when you do get the procedure, they're cutting your neck right here, they're taking it out, and your voice, they say, like, you could lose your voice, or your voice won't be the same, so, that's for one reason, like, or two reasons, so, yeah, but I'm thinking about it, and I really want to get it done, because the more I sit here and let the pain keep thriving, and I mean, it's like a huge, I know I still showed you guys in my vlog one time how huge it was, but it's really huge, and it stretched out your neck too as well, so that's why you see, like, fat right there. I don't know if it's fat or what, but it's been taking me through a roller coaster, and I gotta get that done. So let's talk about my type 2 diabetes. So when I had found out about that, and that had really kind of destroyed the way I feel about myself. The doctor's like, after you had your child, go back to the doctor, because that, it seems like it's in your bloodline, like, hereditary. And I didn't believe it until I went back. Because when I was, like, pregnant with AJJ, I had, what is it? Digestional, I don't know how to pronounce it, but it was diabetes. It's like when you get pregnant, you get, you know, if you don't take care of yourself, you're eating a lot, you get on the border type diabetes. So I didn't believe it until, like, I had to call a freaking nurse to the house. And, I mean, my mom, she was helping me too as well. But you have to, like, push insulin in your stomach and insulin in your thigh. It was hard, and it was like, I don't know, it was crazy, because I was like, from a 160 girl, like 160 pound girl, to diabetes, to thyroids, like it really, like, messed up the way I think about things. And when I figured that out, I started emotional eating, like eating. I won't, like, go into, like, detail about my type 2 diabetes, because I really don't want to talk about that, because it's been with me for so long that I now, like, don't even try to, like, go to the doctor to help myself out, you know. And I know that's bad, because I could die from it. I could lose a feet. I could lose hands. I can, with diabetes, you have, like, these burning, tingling sensation in your feet, to your hands. And I've dealt with it, because at my job, at first they didn't have, like, you know, insurance. So I couldn't go to the doctor. And I know that I could have, because my mom's telling me, you can go get free help. You can get free help. And I just decided work was more important than my diabetes. So now that, you know, it's real, I've made an appointment. I've made an appointment for myself, and I'm excited, you guys, to go and get, like, my whole women's checkup. So, yeah. So, we're going to talk about me trying to go to different stores, trying to fit into clothes, because the clothes didn't fit. Like, I know that I gained weight because my clothes, when I was, like, 160, they didn't fit. When I went to the store and I was getting, like, size 12s and 13s, boo, girl, they did not fit at all. They were snug. They were tight. I couldn't breathe. And it's all with the C-section, because I did not, after I had Ashton, I did not pop back into shape. Like most, I did not pop back. Everybody's like, you're going to pop back? You're going to pop? No, boo-boo. I didn't pop back. I did exercise. I did a membership, gym membership. I tried to do everything, and I didn't pop back. But I learned to love myself and learned to love what God gave me. And even though I couldn't get in the clothes that I wanted to get into, like that too pace, you know, I'm happy that, you know, I'm here and alive. It's not mostly about the fat. It's mostly about, like, changing my lifestyle. Like, mostly, like, getting that weight down and being able to enjoy life and not have to think about, you know, if I'm ever going to be back in that size. You know, I'm in a 14 now, size 14. Size large shirt. My goal is to get down to a medium shirt. My goal is to get back to that 12, 13, or 13. And my goal is to be at least like 160, 165. So, yeah, I'm excited for the journey and my lifestyle and all that stuff. Let's talk about inner thigh rubbing. Girls, y'all know about that inner thigh rubbing. Like, I know you know about that inner thigh rubbing. Like, I don't like it. I don't like it at all. Like, every time you walk, Judy just, she decides she wants to rub. She wants to rub. She wants to rub. Or Judy back there. Judy wants to jiggle and shake, you know. And there's nothing wrong with that if you like it. But me personally, I'm not really used to booty juke back there jiggling while I'm walking. Or that inner thigh scrubbing and scraping against each other. No, no, no. And it's getting hot, boo. It's getting hot, okay? I ain't got time to be extra wiping in my thigh area, okay? Because y'all know, we know. You gotta constantly wipe because you sweat in those parts. If you are a little bit, you know, a little bit, how can I say this? If you have extra pounds, you sweat. And I have extra pounds. Not a lot of extra pounds. I want to show you that. So, this right here. It can't be in my life anymore. I'm so sorry to tell you that. But you can't be in my life no more. Because all of that extra rubbing and stuff is not happening. And I've told you guys about my thyroid and why I have this extra. Okay, this is my part right here because, you know, I let that get out of hand. And I'm hoping that I can get this back in order. But this right here, that ain't my fault. That's thyroid fault. That's thyroid fault. Let's play thyroid. But I hope you guys enjoyed my story. It was silly. It was fun. It was a little bit emotional. It was all over the place. You know, I like to ramble. So I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I didn't want this to be a sad, sad story. You know, about how did I gain weight. But I just wanted to tell you guys bits and pieces, and I hope you guys enjoy. Definitely give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And leave me a comment about you. Leave me a comment about your weight loss, or if you are, you know, trying to lose some weight as well, and what are your methods, what are you doing, and all that good stuff. Leave me a happy face. Tell me I'm doing wonderful. No, you guys, but definitely just give us a thumbs up and subscribe for my new followers. Hi, you guys. I'm so glad you made it to my channel, and it is going to be lit, okay?